Next topic of discussion is nature of roots of a quadratic equation. We have seen that the roots of the quadratic equation is given by the quadratic formula. You know that roots of quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 is given by quadratic formula. That is x is equal to minus b plus r minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. This we have seen in the previous class. Now there is some changes this quantity under root, that is b square minus 480. This depends upon the value of this quantity, the nature of the roots of the equation changes. Okay, how it is changing? Let us see. In case if it is b square minus 4ac, when I calculate, it comes to be 0. For example, this value becomes 0. Then what happens under root 0? Your equation becomes x is equal to, your roots become minus b plus r minus root of 0 by 2a. Whether it is root of 0 is 0. Whether you add or you subtract 0, there won't be any change in the value of x. So x is equal to minus b plus 0 by 2a, x is equal to minus b minus 0 by 2a. So plus 0 or minus 0 make no difference. So both the roots are coming, x is equal to minus b by 2a and minus b by 2a, and both are equal. So once the b square minus 4ac, the quantity under root becomes 0, then the roots of the equation are equal and both are real numbers also. They may be rational or irrational, but they are real numbers. Okay. So b square minus 4 is 0, the roots are equal and real. This is one thing. Okay. In case if this is negative, we have seen some questions before. If this is negative, the root of the negative quantity becomes not a real number. We have discussed in the previously done questions. Okay. So the roots become what happened when a b square minus 4 is less than 0, that is negative, then x is equal to minus b plus or minus square root of a negative number by 2a. This part is not real number, so the entire roots, both the roots are not real number. So in that case we will write the equation has no real roots. So two cases we have seen. The third case, let us see. Okay, if it is a positive quantity, b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, means a positive quantity, then what happens is the root will be minus b plus or minus a positive quantity under root by 2a. So minus b plus root of a positive quantity by 2a, x is equal to minus b minus root of a positive quantity by 2a. So this will have some root, okay, and not having the rational number. So minus b plus some rational number or irrational number, or minus b minus that number, are different numbers. So the two roots will not be equal as we did before in case 1. So the two roots will be different or distinct numbers. Two different roots will come. Okay. So this is a positive quantity, so it will be always real. So the roots are distinct and real. One, b square minus 4ac is a positive quantity. So three things we discuss about the b square minus 4ac. Once it is 0, the roots are equal and real. If it is negative, then there is no real root for the equation. If it is positive, then the roots are two real numbers and two distinct, different values they will be having. These are the things we come to know. And the nature of the root is determined by this quantity b square minus 4ac. This one decides whether the equation has real root or not real root. So this quantity has a name, the discriminant of the quadratic equation. So b square minus 4ac is called discriminant of the quadratic equation. These notes are all you will have to write. We will see examples. We will be having questions. We have to check that what kind of roots they have. Here I have taken three examples, okay, to discuss the nature of the roots. Determine the nature of roots. If roots are real, find them for these equations, okay, just for examples. So I'll have to check what for each equation. Take the first one, write what is ABC, okay, 6 here, C is 9. Go for B square minus 4AC, the discriminant. B square minus 4ac, how much you calculate? So it is becoming 6 square minus 4 into 1 into 9. So this is 36 minus 36, 0. So you got the b square minus 4ac is 0. So what is the, as per our that first case we have studied, b square minus 4ac is 0, the roots are equal and real. So right here, roots are equal and are real roots. And real roots. Okay. Now we go to find the roots. What are they? So you know that x is equal to, and they are asking if the roots are real, find them. They are, what are they? Minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. This part is becoming 0. So they are each minus b plus root of 0, that is not required, minus b by 2a, minus b by 2a. By 2a, and they are minus b minus root of 0 by 2a. This both are equal roots. This part we don't have to even write. Just put the values for them. Minus b, minus 6 by 2a. 2 times 1, 2. That is the same thing again. Minus 6 by 2 times 1. So it is becoming minus 3 and minus 3. These are the equal roots. X has 2 values, minus 3, minus 3. Okay, I take up the next question. So that question is checked here. Same thing. Go for ABC. 3B is 2 and C is 1. So B square minus 4AC. 2 square minus 4 into 3 into 1. That is 4 minus 12. Become negative 8. So less than 0. It is less than 0. So what we can say is, the roots are not real number, because b square minus 4 is, it goes under which one? Under root. So no real roots. No real roots. No need to find it also. Roots are not real. So why do we find? So that's done. Take out the next example. Here is a is 2, b is 9, and c is minus 5. B square minus 4ac. 9 square minus 4 into 2 into 5. So this is 81 minus, this is coming to be 40. So it's 41. Okay. So now write the roots here. X is equal to minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. That is minus 9 plus or minus root 41. By 2 into 2, that is minus 9 plus root 41 by 8, by 4. Okay, this is one root, the other one is minus 9 minus root 41 by 4. Two different roots are obtained. They are both real numbers. The root of 41 we can calculate by means approximated its value, and we can go ahead. These also both are real number, but this is, these two are different number also. This is 9 plus root 41, there is minus 9 minus root 41. So distinct roots are obtained. Here only you will have to write, after getting this number, this is positive, you write roots are distinct and real, that we have to write, then go for finding it. Roots are distinct. Distinct and real. Real also. Then you going for finding the roots. So all the nature of roots first, then find out the roots if they are real. See this question now. Find the value of k if the roots of this equation are equal and real. Okay, are equal and real. Equal and real. That's a question. So. Okay, so we know the condition for equal roots and equal and real roots, that is, the discriminant should be 0. So first make it in the proper form, in a quadratic form, and find out what is b square minus 4ac equal to 0. From that you will find the value of k, right? So first make it in the quadratic form, open the bracket, that is becoming kx square minus 2kx plus 6 equal to 0. The equation. Okay, there we find out here what a is k and b is minus 2k and c is 6. Given the condition here, given the roots are equal and real. Are equal and real. You write the condition. Therefore, what is the condition? B square minus, here are B square minus 4ac equal to 0. The condition we have to write. Because the roots are real, B square minus 4ac 0. Real and equal. So minus 2k the whole square minus 4 into k into 6 is equal to 0. This is becoming 4k square minus 24k k equal to 0. Factorize this one. Only two terms are there, taking the highest common factor out. So it is 4k into k minus 6, 0. So each linear factor equal to 0. Do not transpose, equal to 0. So 4k is 0, or k is, or 4 can be transposed, it becomes 0. So k is 0, or k is equal to minus 6. Or k minus 6 is 0, you can tell. So, okay, if k is 0, what is happening? If k is 0, this equation won't be available. The quadratic equations, x square coefficient becomes 0. Even x coefficient becomes 0. It's not possible. So, k is 0 means equation won't be available. So, this is not possible. K cannot be 0. So, what is the value of k? K minus 6 must be 0. Therefore, k minus 6 is 0 gives you k is 6. So, what is the value of k? 6. Sometimes this kind of quadratic things coming, two values of k will obtain. Sometimes both the values may be possible, sometimes one value we have to discard. This is not possible. Depends upon the situation. And this value is possible. The value of k is 6. Okay? So, I have taken some question from your book. We have done some extra questions only. Exercise 4.4. The first question, similar to these, do it by yourself. Question number 2. One bit, second bit I have done. The first bit you have to do as homework. And question number 3 also we have to do. I will explain you question number 4, even 5. And then you can do the question number 3 as homework. See this question number 4 of exercise 4.4. They are asking, is the following situation possible? If so, determine the present ages. They talk about the ages of pattern. Two friends, okay. They say the sum of ages of two friends is 20 years. Total age is 20. 4 years ago, the product of their ages in years was 48. One such a situation is possible or not? So what we do, use the situation, frame a quadratic equation, okay, and check the nature of roots of that equation. If the equation has real roots, then the situation is a real situation. Such situation is possible. Okay? If the equation doesn't have any real roots, so such a situation is not possible in real life. It's not possible. Impossible situation. This is what the question expects from us. Okay? So now we'll take what is given. Sum of ages of two friends is 20, they give you. So let their ages be, have to take totally 20. So one is taken as x, the other we used to take this 20 minus x, the sum minus age of the first person. Okay, let their ages. So you take let the two friends. Okay, let their ages be x and 20 minus x. See, the sum is 20. One age if you take x, the other will be the sum minus that age, the other person, okay? Presently, this is present age. They are talking about the product of their ages, okay? 4 years ago. So, their ages 4 years ago 4 years ago that you make ready. What are they? This person will be having where x minus 4 and the other one, this is 4 less, subtract 4. So 20 minus x minus 4, that will be 16 minus x. Okay, these are the ages. 4 years ago, the ages 4 years ago were like this. They talk about the product of these ages. Given as per question, the product of these ages, x minus 4 multiplied by 16 minus x, these are multiplied and is 48. They say that is equal to 48. This gives you the equation. Okay, frame the equation and you go for finding the value of its discriminant and test the nature of the roots of this equation. So I write multiplying here, 16x minus x square minus 64 plus 4x equal to 48. So taking everything on the side, this I can simplify further. So minus x square plus 20x minus 64 equal to 48. All taken other side, this side will be 0, x square minus 20x. This is added other side. This is becoming plus 48 plus 64. Okay, this is 112. So your equation becomes x square minus 20x plus 112 equal to 0. Equation came in the standard form. I'll have to check the nature of roots. So take a root, b square minus 4 is 1 root, a is 1, b is minus 20, and c is 112. I find what is b square minus 4 is. The discriminant value, how much? B square minus 4 into 1 into 112. This is coming to be 400 minus 448. Okay, this is 4 times 112. So this is coming negative 48. So it is less than 0. So the equation has no real roots. Therefore, the situation is impossible. Such a situation is not possible. If it is possible, you will have to find out what are the roots and tell what are the present ages of the person can be got. But such a situation does not arise anywhere. So we write here, the equation has no real roots. The equation has no real roots. Hence the situation is not possible. Not real situation. Hence the situation is not possible. Impossible situation. Okay? Let's do one more question. Question number 5. Question number 4 is this. Question number 3, do at home by yourself. I take out one more question. Similar questions you can try. Okay? What are that? See, next question is asking, is it possible to design a rectangular part whose perimeter is 80 meters and the area is 400 square meters, If so, find the length and breadth. They have given perimeter and length and breadth you are going to take. You take length or breadth, anything as x. So let the length be x. Same way we have to do, let the length of the rectangle x meters take, okay? Perimeter, you know, perimeter they have given. Perimeter of the rectangle. Rectangular field is given to be 80. From that you make out the breadth of it. So that is what is length into 2 times length plus breadth. 80. You make breadth in term of x now. So length plus breadth is 40. You are taking the length as x. Okay, so I did x in this place of L. This 2 transpose that side and get value of B. So breadth is equal to 40 minus x. So length is x, breadth is 40 minus x. Both the length and breadth are available in terms of x now. So you have taken x as length and perimeter they gave From that, you know, from the perimeter, how do you find out? Half the perimeter minus length is breadth. You know that one. Otherwise, you do like this way. So, length and breadth are ready in terms of x. I will apply what else is given. This is the area of the rectangle is 400. You write given. Okay. Area is 400 meter square. That is length into breadth. That is 400. Put them in terms of x. So x into 40 minus x is 400. Open the bracket and 40x minus 6 square is 400. Taking everything to one side, get as x square minus 40x plus 400. We get a quadratic equation. I have to go for checking the nature of it. Nature of the roots of this equation. So I check the nature here. B square minus 4ac, find out first. So minus 40 square minus 4 into 1 into 400. This is coming 1600 minus 1600. Both the beginning 0. So the roots are equal and real. So situation possible, real situation. Roots are equal and real. Now let's go for roots. That is x will be, as I told you before, only minus b by 2a minus b by 2a. Or minus b by 2a and itself. There is no discriminant, that's it, becomes 0. So I write what is minus b by 2a, that is going to be my value of x. So x is equal to minus b by 2a. You know what is minus b here is minus of minus 40. So minus of minus 40 by 2a, 2 times 1. So this is becoming 40 by 2, that is 20. So x is 20, means length is 20. Length is equal to 20 meters and breadth, you know, what is the breadth is 40 minus 6. So 40 minus 20, that also 20 meters. So your length and breadth indeed become equal. Huh? So it doesn't matter, it is square. You know, a square is also a rectangle. So length and breadth are both equal. Situation is possible situation. So this is how we have to end it. Okay. So as I told you, question number 3. A similar thing. Try the same way you follow. Do it at home. Now with this the chapter ends. I'll give you a worksheet to solve. Have to do all type of question. The worksheet will cover. So solve that and revise complete chapter, be thorough in it. We will have to move to the next chapter in the next session.